space, please? I need everybody to move back. Move back, please. Can I get your autograph?
Yeah, sure. What's your name?
It's Vince.
In love, Mary Fraser Hall.
I see you're a fan of the show.
Yeah.
Get these f***ing people away from me.
We're shooting season 3 now. It's definitely fun to have the cameras following us again, but it has a bit of a different vibe this season.
How are things between you and Jeff?
As you know, Jeff and I got together at the end of last season, but things changed after the show aired on TV.
So if we get the statement of defense by Wednesday, we're gonna need everyone to review the contractual terms. What the hell?
I was trying to make the scene.
Oh, good for you, and how was it? Hope it was good for you, because we're going to have to do it again.
I'm sorry, Mr. Manageli.
For f***'s sake, man. You amateur. Let's do it again.
Let's just take a minute.
F***, let's not take another minute. Let's do it again.
One day, you're just a normal student. And the next, people know the most intimate details about your personal life. Most of us handled it just fine, but things went to Jeff's head. So I ended things between us. Before they even really started.
I'm the most genuine, normal person you'll ever meet. I ran into this guy downtown the other day, and he said his friend asked me for my autograph, and I blew him off. I'm like, that is not possible. If you speak to my publicist through jeffmaranangeli.com and send a self-addressed postage-paid envelope, you will receive an 8x10 autographed glossy within 4 to 10 weeks. Just make sure it's a colored glossy, none of that black and white shit. I find it really accentuates my T-zone. Final season of Murray Fraser Hall. I was talking with the network about a possible spin-off series that will chronicle my articling years in Toronto. Thinking of a number of titles, Jeff Takes T.O., Bay Street Blues, Overruled starring Jeff. You know what? I like that one. Hey, write that down. Listen, team, this is the problem left and right. I'm trying to find good f***ing case law, and you're like, I'm working on it, or I can't find it. Damn it, I'm trying to win here.
It's because, like, you're insulting me.
That's not what I meant. You know, Jeff's changed a lot since last year. We, as everybody I think knows, we won the McLaren move. And after we did, all that success just kind of went to his head. And now he's walking around like he's some kind of Hollywood star or something like that. Anyways, we're in the Dixon mood this year. And, you know, we've heard it's quite a bit harder. So, you know, we'll see.
All right, guys, check it out. Have you looked at this legal test for our case? There's no support here. I'm going out on a limb, trying to create a winning team. You guys are pushing me down. You know, like the man's been pushing us brothers down for centuries.
I don't get Jeff. He attended the Canadian BET Awards last year, and now he thinks he has some special connection with black people.
I don't think fame should be squandered. Last year, I was asked to appear at a lot of events. And since participating at the Canadian BET Awards, I think I've really developed a strong bond with the black, African-Canadian community.
We still need better research on the statutes.
I know. Why don't we just ask Melissa to help us with some research? Wasn't she great on the Moot team last year?
I don't know about that. I haven't really spoken to Melissa in a while.
You're aware they have a history.
What? No! I didn't know they had a history.
Well, we can't use two cases, the Proctor case and the RW case. Scott, what do you got?
Well, does everyone like the Stevens case? I'm just throwing it out there.
Well, guess what? I'm just throwing it back. It's 1982, the charter's just about to be signed, and you crumple it up and throw it in the trash. Luckily, I come along, see it, and take it out of the trash. And you're like, I'm just throwing it out there. You threw out the Charter of Rights and Freedoms, you idiot.
There's your coffee, Jeff.
Is there cream in this coffee? I think there's cream in this coffee. You know, all I need is a double soy. You keep this up, you're gonna be out of a job.
I don't wanna lose my job.
That's what people who don't wanna lose their job say. They're not gonna say, I'm glad to lose my job. Oh no, on the floor.
So after the fallout with Jeff and Melissa in season 2, the network essentially wrote me off the show.
Apparently, I didn't click with the 18 to 24 demographic. But Jeff was nice enough to hire me as his personal assistant. We had to convert one of the library study rooms into his personal dressing room because of all the crazy fans and stresses that come with being on a reality show.
I know a lot of people are going to come see one of those Voices in Law talks this afternoon, but I think the real show is going to be me taping a very dramatic mood scene. I'm really going to tear Scott a new one.
Just don't forget you've got an autograph signing at 2 o'clock. You don't want to be late.
What's that? Did you just talk over me again? Seriously, man, get your fucking head straight. When the Supreme Court is making a decision, you don't start rambling about traffic tickets. I might be a f***ing genius or the biggest dick ever, I don't know. But what I do know is when I nail my catchphrase this afternoon, the audience is gonna go crazy. That verdict is void. Ab initio.
They are gonna love you. Your chakra, it's like... centered.
I can always rely on you, my guru Moonbeam.
Hey Jeff, I just want to remind you, I got you booked in for 2 appearances tomorrow, but don't worry, I'm gonna make sure you're well taken care of.
Don't talk to me like I'm a f***ing child. These f***ing appearances are draining.
I know, but season 3 is almost over and it's gonna calm down soon, so just, you know, just think of all the people that you're gonna make so happy.
Yeah, that's what they said about Jesus.
You didn't just compare yourself to Jesus.
Jeff, you're great. Your chakra is totally aligned.
What the f***?
Hey Jeff, we'll need you in about 15 minutes.
Did I want all the attention? Of course not. We agreed to have the film crew follow us for 10 months, but I never thought I was going to get this out of hand. I mean, I came here to study law. Now it's just a f***ing zoo.
So what's next?
I have this spin-off series in development. I guess it will go from Jeff the law student to Jeff the articling student. I just do what the producers tell me. I also have this quick law endorsement deal with LexisNexis.
So do you find it difficult to manage relationships due to the show's success?
Hold on a second. Oh, look at this. I don't believe this guy. You play 9 holes with someone and they think you're buddies. Anyway, where were we? Oh, that's right, relationships. You wanted to talk about Melissa. The truth is, she's moved on. She's done with me.
I didn't ask about Melissa.
You could be wrong, Jeff. I blew my chance with her last year, but you still have something. You're the same guy she met in first year, not some TV prick.
Did I tell you to speak? God, stand over there. A little further.
We're shooting the graduation episode in May, then that's it. We're all going in different directions. I'll be articling here in town. Christy's going to a big firm. John will be serving coffee at the Supreme Court. And Jeff has a TV deal back in Toronto. Who knows, maybe one day people will ask me if I was that girl from Murray Fraser Hall.
Law school's hard enough as it is, and making it into a TV show, that just makes it harder.
You've got to strip away the cameras, the fans, the fame, the autographs, and remember what you really came here for.
Sure, I'm happy I did it. I have no regrets. It's just that things didn't really end up exactly as I had planned.
Melissa, can I talk to you for a second?
What do you want, Jeff?
Look, I'm sorry for everything. I need you to know that none of that stuff mattered to me. I forgot the real reason why I loved coming to law school every day.
What about your articles? The TV deal in Toronto?
Forget about that. I need to stay here, where everything started.
Then maybe we could start again. But I'm a lucky man with fire in my hands.
Happiness, something in my own place. I'm studio naked, smiling. I feel I can't work after hearing dead babies. Because I already smiled, the shot was ruined.
Right?
Westlaw.